What's going on, everyone? I'm just a typical, average American here today to react and continue learning about 101 random facts about the UK. Part 2! If you haven't seen part 1, feel free to go check that out or stay right here in part 2. That's perfectly fine as well. But in part 1, I started learning things about the UK that I didn't know that I needed to know. Such as that London is not just the capital of England, but the capital of the UK. I really feel like I should have known that one. I'm a bit embarrassed to not knowing that one. England has like over 80% of the population of the UK lives in England. I had no idea England had that majority of the proportion of the people living in the UK. And what else did I learn? That people in the UK drink 20 times more tea than Americans, which is just the least surprising fact ever, to be honest. But this is why I've been enjoying this video so much, is it just has the most random, but like useful or informative facts ever. Like stuff that I feel like I would never have ran into any other way, except on a random video with just endless facts being thrown at me about the UK. So for that reason, I'm quite excited to see what kind of facts I'm gonna learn today about the UK. We got a whole bunch more to get through, so let's take a look.
Number 34. Speaking of heart attack, a popular national food of Scotland is haggis. Sheep heart, liver, and mince encased...
Haggis. Sometimes somehow the haggis finds a way to pop up in a lot of videos that I watch about the UK. I'm still coming around on haggis. This is the stomach with all of the animal parts shoved in it, right?
In a stomach. Mmm. You want some haggis, Americans? Hmm? Do you want some haggis?
Now, apparently it's like pretty good. Like, obviously, like it's famous. I've heard of the word, even here in America. But, gosh, it is just the least American thing possible, honestly. So, no offense, but it kind of terrifies me.
25? Well, that's too bad, because it's illegal to import haggis from the UK into the US, as the American government has declared that sheep lungs are unfit for human consumption. I mean...
Really? I mean, you probably shouldn't be mailing animal organs anyway. But the fact that haggis in particular is just like illegal to send to America is funny in a way, but I guess it makes sense. Like, how would you even keep it fresh? And then the American you send it to would just be terrified, thinking it's like a human, or, you know, a human spleen or something. It's just bad news.
How dare they? Have they tried American chocolate? It tastes like disappointment in a bar. Number 36. The Christmas tree in Trafalgar Square is presented every year by the people of Oslo in gratitude for London's assistance during World War II.
Wow.
Number 37.
Oh, that's really cool. A tree in Trafalgar Square. Is that part of London? I think it is. Oh, for help during World War II. That's really cool.
James Bond, or Secretive Jimmy, as I call him down the pub, is one of Britain's national heroes.
Right.
And one of the first people I did 101 facts about, don't you know?
Oh.
His code name, 007, was inspired by the author Ian Fleming's bus route from Canterbury to London.
So really?
Not only do you know that now, but you also know the bus route to get from Canterbury to London.
007 was inspired by a bus number. That is the kind of random fact that I come here for. Very good.
You're welcome. Number 38. The London Underground Subway, or the Tube, is one of the oldest subways in the world.
Really?
The 409 escalators and tube stations cover the distance every week, which is approximately equivalent to several trips around the world. So you probably can't ride them all in a day, I'm afraid. Sorry to quash that dream.
There's 400 escalators. The London Tube is apparently massive. Like, I can't even appreciate how big it is, because I don't even have a sense of how big London is, to be honest. I'm very bad at that. But the Tube is also one of the oldest underground rail systems as well. I did not know that. But it kind of makes sense. with how old the history of just Britain in general is, huh?
Number 39. Despite being named as such, more than half of the London Underground is, in fact, above, not under, ground.
What? What?
Number...
Wait, what? Yeah, that... See? This is, again, why I love it. I really thought, especially based on the name, the nickname, London Underground, I thought it was all underground. More than half is above ground? It's just a regular train system? See, that, maybe that's just so obvious to people like living in London or the UK, but at no point along the line, even learning about the London Underground, did I ever hear this. Okay.
In fact, above, not under, ground.
I feel decept, deceited, deception, disillusioned. okay, that's good to know.
Number 40. The longest escalator in a tube station, incidentally, is at the station Angel, and is the fourth longest escalator in the world. I should
really?
Know, I used to ride the bloody thing all the time, but then I realised that skiing down it is far better, like this guy does.
Oh my god.
Number 41. A new breed of mosquito was found in the tube tunnels in 1998. Scientists believe it mutated from a species that came to the London Underground when it was built in the last century.
No. Different species of mosquitoes are breeding down in the London Underground. That's something I maybe didn't need to know. I didn't need to know that.
It has since evolved into separate species.
Huh?
The meaning of life. Oh, hey, London, by the way, hosted the 2012 Olympics in, 2012.
Right.
This was the third time they did so. The first in 1908 and the second in 1948.
Oh, okay.
Number 43. Okay. Wales is actually home to a town called... Oh, bloody hell, really? Do you expect me to read that? Okay, let's give this a go. Llanfair Llanfairpwll Gwynedd...
Oh, they have a sign that helps you say it. Llanfairpwll Gwynedd Gwyrgyrro Cwyrndrobwll Llanasilo Gwgwgwch. What? Is that a Welsh... Like, have a Welsh meaning or something? And it's just like, You know, no matter what the meaning is this really necessary? I have to ask.
Queen Drobulf. The land for. Oh, screw it. Naomi Watts, help me out here.
There's. Okay, so the people who have lived there actually know how to say it. And it's like, even with the helpful sign guide, I wasn't saying it anywhere near correctly.
Thank you. This translates to St. Mary's Church in the Hollow of the White Hazel near a rapid whirlpool at the Church of St. Tisilo near the cave.
I don't know about this. Like, okay, it translates to something very meaningful. Okay, very nice. But you don't gotta make a whole sentence the name of your town. I'm sorry, no matter who you are.
Which is just as snappy. You go, Wales. Number 4. There's only a 21-mile gap between England and France, and the countries are connected by the Channel Tunnel, which opened in 1994.
I learned about this. I was absolutely mind-blown by this. I had no idea how close the UK was to France. No idea, like, somehow. And that they actually built a tunnel, a literal tunnel. I remember learning about this. This was awesome.
It's the world's second longest underground tunnel. And no, you can't see fishies out the window like I thought you could. I know. I was just as disappointed as you.
That would almost be kind of scary, in a way. Going through this underground tunnel. Like, knowing that there's just endless amounts of earth above you. Like, and you're just in this tunnel underground. There's something a bit scary about that.
Number 45. John and Mary, nope, not those two, that was so last month, have been revealed as the most popular male and female names of the last 500 years in the UK.
John and Mary. Yeah, that makes sense. Those are the most UK names I've ever heard. John and Mary. Yeah, John is very popular in the United States as well.
I'm sure Sherlock has joined them now, along with twerk and Brexit, probably. Hashtag satire.
Oh, boy.
Number 46. A new study shows that Smith, Jones, and Williams have been the most common surnames for nearly 180 years.
Again, these are really common in the United States as well. Yeah, Smith, Jones, Williams. Yeah, that's pretty common here as well, to be honest.
Have been the most common surnames for nearly 180 years.
Not shocking.
So there's going to be plenty of Twerk Joneses out there soon. Wow, that kind of sounds like a detective. Twerk Jones.
Wow.
Number 47. Speaking of twerking, kind of. According to The Sun, most Brits will have rumpy pumpy love time.
Sex.
A total of 4,239 times in their lives. Just one more time for me and I've beaten the app.
What is this random stat? Okay. Things I really didn't know I needed to know. Okay.
Bridge.
How do they calculate this?
I think it's around 4,239 more times.
Okay.
And a half. Number
48. We're just learning about, like, history and tunnels and infrastructure and geography. And then there's just this random, like, sex stat out of nowhere. Okay.
When the UK was asked what our favourite steamy position for sexy time is, we answered near unanimously with 31% of us saying, "I don't have a favourite." Wow, we are a decisive bunch, us lot. Number 49.
Okay.
We bloody love fish and chips.
No. They just snuck that in there and now we're back to fish and chips, okay.
Some Yorkshire puddings and gravy and crumpets over here, the stereotype is true.
Yeah.
Which is probably the reason why England has the highest rate of obesity in Europe.
Okay.
That said,
In Europe. I was going to say, like, wait a minute. Highest rates of obesity in the world or in Europe? Okay, because America is not in Europe.
Do you spend a lot of calories queuing up for stuff? Wow, I'm being really racist to myself here. Number 50! The United Kingdom has brought some of the world's greatest musical artists ever, including the Beatles,
true,
Robbie Williams, the Rolling Stones, Queen, Black Sabbath, Robbie Williams, David Bowie, The Who, Oasis, Iron Maiden,
seriously, especially when you spell it out like this, like, the UK is literally responsible for some of the literal greatest ever bands and performers. Like, it's pretty amazing.
The Williams and, of course, the Spice Girls. So, yeah.
Of course.
You're welcome, rest of the world. Number 51. In fact, the Beatles are the highest selling and most successful musical artist of all time.
Right.
And they came straight out of the UK.
Yeah.
Liverpool, to be precise.
Yeah. I wonder how popular the Beatles are to, like, the newest generations now. Because I feel like I was born just in time for my parents to, like, teach me about the Beatles and listen to some CDs when I was younger of the Beatles. And now I wonder, it's like, do kids that are, like, kids that are 10, 15, even 20, like, are do they even know, like, Beatles songs anymore, I wonder.
Number 52. TV and soaps are also a big dealio. The most watched TV episode of all time in the UK was of a soap set in London called EastEnders. Specifically, an episode in 1986 on Christmas Day, which pulled in 30 million viewers.
EastEnders? I've never even heard of this. This must have been a good show.
Number 53.
Oh my god.
We also love our comedy over here, given that we invented the concept. And have produced many, many funny shows and sitcoms,
yes,
this not included.
Yes.
A YouGov poll found that the sitcom considered the funniest and most popular is Only Fools and Horses.
Only Fools and Horses? Of all the British comedy, Only Fools and Horses is the funniest? Really? Really?
Number 54.
What is that?
In 2014, 10,908 umbrellas were lost on the London Underground, as well as 20,000 mobile phones. So if you need to get dry and get a new phone, hop on the tube, you know.
I'm actually surprised it's that big. 20,000 phones lost in 1 year? That's like hundreds every day. What the heck?
Never know what you might find. Number 55. A human skull and prosthetic legs have also been found in London without their owner. Oh, Bethnal Green, that's where I left my human skull.
What?
I ruined that performance of Hamlet using a basketball instead.
Okay.
Number 56.
I mean, I'm sure there's been human skulls reported and not reported found in various cities around the US, so.
It was just above a pub named the Red Lion on Great Windmill Street in London that Karl Marx made his marks by drafting the Communist Manifesto.
Ah.
It's now a Be at One cocktail bar, which is, I'm sure, what he would have wanted.
Okay.
Number 57. Football, or soccer ball, as it's known, is a massive part of UK culture. In fact, it's such a phenomenon...
Thank you for so I can understand. Oh, soccer ball. Now I know what we're talking about.
That some YouTube channels do videos about football daily. You're welcome, guys. There's your shout out. Now, stop flooding my inbox with pictures of Joe naked, please. Number 58. We love football so much, as a nation, not Clive and I individually, we're more into bowling, that there are over 5,300 clubs, 7,000 teams, and over 100 stadiums across the UK.
Wow, I mean, this can't be overstated. How big of a cultural difference this is. Especially spelled out like this. Like, here in America, soccer, or football, is, like, semi-popular. I'm not going to say it's a niche sport, but it's just like that extra sport some people do. It's more common than, like, I don't know, like bowling or darts or what have you. Probably more, is it on par with golfing? Golfing is probably more popular. And, American football and basketball and baseball are probably more popular. So football, or as we call soccer, is quite down on the list of, like, sports in America. It's funny because it's so popular in Europe, as I know.
Number 59. But not everyone likes football. Many kings, such as Edward II, III, and IV, and Richard II, wanted to actually ban the beautiful game completely.
What? Why?
Number 6.
Wow. Football was almost just straight up banned. Cut out of history. Hundreds of years ago. That'd be awful sad, huh?
Okay. Even Shakespeare apparently disapproved of football, specifically mentioning it with disdain in his play A Comedy of Errors.
What?
Your defense is terrified. Shakespeare's on fire.
What's with all the ancient, the historical hate towards football? What is their specific grievance with it?
Number 61. Speaking of willies, sausages. That was the most immature thing I think I've ever done. Sausages are very popular here in the UK. They were introduced by the Romans around AD 400, and there are now 470 recipes for British bangers.
Oh my gosh.
Number 60.
That's another random thing. Like, football. Really popular in the UK. Kind of popular in America. Same thing with sausage, I feel like. Sausage seems quite popular in the UK. It's just kind of something we sometimes think about in America.
62. Our smallest city is St. David's in Pembrokeshire, with a population of 1,797.
Okay.
In my mind, it's exactly like Hot Fuzz over there. Number 63. The highest temperature ever recorded in England was 38.5 Celsius, which is 101.3 Fahrenheit.
Oh my god. 101.
On August the 10th, 2003.
101. I feel like... I feel like in parts of the United States, it's probably gotten a bit higher than that, actually. Like 101 Fahrenheit? I think so.
Single man in the UK probably took their top off and got immensely sunburnt, because that, after all, is the British way.
Wow.
Nintendo 64. However, the UK's weather is renowned for raining.
Oh, wait. 64. Okay, we got a couple more to go until we hit 66, then we'll be... two-thirds of the way through this?
All the pissing time, and yes, that can be true. In fact, the Met Office found that in Snowdonia, the Lake District, and the Scottish Highlands, they received more than 4 meters of rainfall in a year. 4 meters!
Oh my god. Why is that? That is something I've wondered about, because rain in, like, the UK, it's, like, known for rain. And I'm just... thinking, like, scientifically, what is the reason for that more than other places, you know?
Number 65. Le Français was actually the official language of England for around 300 years.
Really?
From 1066 till about 1362.
Really?
Sounds like I was there, or I wasn't actually. I'm not that old, although sometimes I do feel that.
I'm actually surprised by that. Like, if you think about it, if your official language of your nation was French for 300 years. 300 years! Many generations of people. I would expect it to never change. Like, the fact that it changed to English after that, it's pretty astounding to me. There must have been some major, like, regime and historical changes in who was controlling and leading Britain for it to change languages. Think about now changing, like, the language of, like, the US or the UK. Just being like, okay, everyone, we're changing languages. Like, it's impossible. So that's interesting.
Number 66.
Okay.
If you think we're all stuffy and boring over here, well, let me tell you, we're bloody not. In fact, the world's second largest second-hand book market can be found in Hay-on-Wye, a small village at the border of England and Wales. So, yeah.
The world's largest what?
Let me tell you, we're bloody not. In fact, the world's second largest second-hand book market can be found in
The world's second biggest second-hand book market. They sell used books? The second most on Earth. Okay.
And why? A small village at the border of England and Wales. So, yeah. I think we know how to party. Thank you very much.
Wow.
Number 66.
Okay, that's that is the most random fact that I think of this entire video. And I think we're going to end here for now. We're at 66, 67 out of 101. We're two-thirds of the way through. I am learning. My brain is processing so much UK knowledge that I'm trying to sort out the useful information to the not-so-useful, like the world's second-biggest second-hand book market. I'm already forgetting where it is, which is probably for the best, but most of this information is actually quite interesting. Very fascinating. Again, I love hearing the random facts about the UK. The stuff that I just would never run into any other way. It's really, really fun and interesting. So I think we'll stop now and complete this in part 3. So if you've enjoyed this so far, feel free to give this video a like or leave a comment. Perhaps your thoughts on any of these facts we've learned so far. And if you're interested in part 3 or more videos in general like this, me reacting to the UK and UK culture, feel free to subscribe for more. And until then, thanks for watching and see you next time.